I wasn't expecting much from Insomniac's new game. With just 2 years of development time, it seemed Spider-Man Miles Morales would amount to a less substantial reskin of the original game. A new mechanic or two, some weather effects to update the city, and a DLC-length narrative. The same quality as we got before, but with a slightly different flavor. And as far as the crucial web-swinging mechanics go, all we had to go on from the game's announcement were these clips. And a month or two later, this. So I was as happy as anyone when it turned out to be like... So considering the new system consists 90% of the same functions as before, just what makes these mechanics such an improvement over an already solid system? Well, let's do this numerically. First, there's the little things. Players were given a lot of navigation options in the previous game, but Miles Morales smooths out a lot of little snags along the way. For example, a mid-air dodge used to look and feel a bit awkward, locking up your movement for a second or two. Now, you can transfer your dodge momentum directly into a new swing. Jumping off the side of a building to web swing used to look like this. Looks cool, but you can't do anything during that flipping animation. But in Miles Morales, you regain full control immediately. Your point launch works from a slightly greater distance than before, which gives you more options at a given moment, and decreases downtime between swings and point launches. And probably most notable of all, your air tricks are much more integrated into the rest of your animations. Rather than existing in total isolation from the rest of your movements, air tricks now flow smoothly into one another, as well as into your swings. These little tweaks add up to a much slicker gameplay experience that's a little hard to fully appreciate until you go back and play the first game and come to the realization that it feels a lot stiffer and more sluggish than you might remember, especially during those air trick animations. Speaking of which... this is where things get innovative. Miles' animations are pretty distinct from Peter's, full of flailing limbs and recklessness, a daredevil energy that emphasizes his youthful excitement compared to Peter's experience and deficiency. And this new style is nowhere more obvious than when you're engaging in the game's overhauled air trick system. What we had before was limited to about 4 tricks initiated by a slightly clunky input. Just a little touch to give us something to do in between swings and reap some small XP rewards. There was a slight delay between input and the animation starting, and the various flips and twirls didn't necessarily flow naturally into one another when switching them up quickly. But Miles Morales is another game entirely in the trick department. 2 dozen tricks. Seamless and responsive animations you can rapidly, almost instinctively combo together. Enough moves to keep up variety over much longer stretches of gameplay. And to a much greater extent, you're incentivized to think not only about your movement through the city, but how you look in the process. Sure, Miles looks pretty stylish even if you never tap that air trick button, but there's a world of dazzling moves right at your fingertips that can spice things up at any moment. There's enough tricks that trying out random combinations of analog stick directions will usually provide some surprises and some rarely seen animations. And as you get used to the system, you'll memorize more and more of the moves at your disposal, making it possible to trigger specific moves whenever you feel the time is right. Not only are there a couple dozen tricks available ordinarily while in midair, but you get additional sets of moves depending on whether you're doing a standard front-facing dive or a backward one. For me, this system has a big effect on the moment-to-moment experience, because I'm a bit less focused on practical stuff. That is, whether I want to swing or zip or wall run at a given moment, but now, equally, what cool moves I want to see my on-screen Spidey perform. The wish fulfillment inherent to web swinging becomes even greater when your attention turns from mere navigation to choreographing a dazzling display of acrobatic feats on the fly. Although the previous game had some pretty neat animations, you unfortunately would come across the same ones dozens and dozens and dozens of times over hours of play. So having unique swing animations accompany the majority of these new tricks results in much less repetition and a lot more opportunities to show off as you try to pack in as many distinct moves as possible. And reducing the proportion of animations that are purely randomized and beyond player control can only be a good thing when the player's main concern is trying to look really cool. In general, seeing awesome stuff and knowing you're in precise control of it is a satisfying feeling, even when what you're doing doesn't directly impact the efficiency of your movement. Ultimately, what this adds up to is an increased potential for player expression. Every player is going to approach these mechanics differently and end up with a more distinct style than they might have had in the first game with its more limited and randomized moveset. Personally, I like deviating from my destination now and then and chaining together as many air tricks as possible during my airtime.
That was lit!
There are these amazing moments when I go into sort of a flow state, rapidly performing moves, and for a moment, losing track of where I'm going and what I'm doing and just trust that I'll be able to smoothly swing out of my chaotic spiral at the last moment. So you'll probably find a player like me messing around with the system a bit more than a player more focused on efficiency. It's like playing a different game when you get caught up in pushing this trick system as far as it can go. And speaking of tricks, what's a self-respecting video game without some tangible rewards? Which brings us to... yeah, the other big new mechanic, your Venom powers. All the pre-release marketing focused on Venom as a new combat mechanic, but it actually plays into traversal in a big way, allowing you to either quickly gain elevation or fling yourself quickly forward for an unbroken burst of momentum. So it's a lot easier to clear obstacles, as you now essentially have a super web zip or a mid-air charge jump. But better yet, these new moves also play well with the revamped air trick system. As you flip this way and that in midair, you charge up your Venom meter, enabling more boosts. So you've not only got the built-in reward of showing off while you get around, but you also receive a very concrete reward for your acrobatic indulgences that gives you more traversal options. The more work you put into pulling off tricks, the more often you can rocket over rooftops or gain instant momentum when you need it. This immediately adds depth to a system that was fairly clean-cut before. You previously had approximately 4 meaningful options when in midair, but now, with Venom abilities at your disposal, and a whole trick system required to enable them, you'll have a few more choices to make at a given moment. Take this building. In either game, you could wall run up and use the rooftop for a web vault to build some speed, but now, you'll also have the option to Venom boost your way to the rooftop much more quickly than a wall run would allow, but only if you've built up enough Venom energy. Alternatively, you could quickly redirect around the building using a Venom dash. These are just some examples of how these moves can provide benefits and trade-offs alongside the existing moveset. At the very least, you'll have fewer moments when you're just falling and waiting for an opportunity to do something meaningful. Miles' new moves help eliminate the downtime and keep the gameplay more active. Granted, it's easy to miss out on a lot of this new system. I'm not proud to admit that I didn't even realize front-facing Venom dashes were possible until after I'd completed the game the first time, and your performance won't exactly take a huge hit for failing to make these mechanics staples of your playstyle. But there is a massive influx of potential now. There's also a newfound sense of... that's right! There's a risk-reward component to the gameplay now. You've obviously got something to gain by doing lots of air tricks, but if you don't do them quickly enough, you might lose out on a nice opportunity to Venom boost your way over this building. Or in a better example, if you don't swing out of an air trick in time, you can actually splat face first into the ground. There's no fall damage, but being able to outright screw up and hit the pavement with a loss of momentum is something that was absent in the previous game, despite a number of earlier Spider-Man games including such punishing mechanics. If you saw my last video on how the classic Spider-Man 2 stacks up against Insomniac's web-swinging system, you'll recall that the 2018 game's stance on punishing the player went something like this.
We are not going to have fall damage in the game. It was about making sure that everybody feels like a superhero.
Wish fulfillment and a sense of character-appropriate ease have always been the goal of Insomniac's system, so making a show of player mistakes like this is an interesting decision. And although a lot of fans argue that the most ideal solution is to directly combine both these styles, it seems to me like a challenging yet rewarding system, and a relaxing, instantly intuitive one, might be difficult approaches to reconcile without losing some of the benefits of each. But I think Insomniac has found a really clever loophole by restricting these failure states to the optional trick system. So you can still have a carefree swinging experience if you like, but you can also engage in risk-taking when it suits you. But most of the time, you have to be deliberately trying to mess up, as it's still possible to fire off a web mid-air trick inches from street level and pull off a perfect swing. So maybe the presence of risk in that equation isn't as significant as it could be. Which brings me to the next section of this video. With Marvel's Spider-Man 2 being all but officially confirmed at this point, where can Insomniac's web-swinging go from here? Well, that's something I'm a lot more optimistic about after playing Miles Morales. And the strengths of this game point the way to a number of improvements that can be made on top of an already strong system. But before that, I just want to ask, I can't be the only one who sees this and immediately thinks... Tony Hawk's Pro Skater is a really well-known gaming franchise created by Neversoft, who did the old PS1 Spider-Man game that I grew up playing.
Tony Hawk! Hey, I skated with that guy.
And it's gotta be one of the most complex and demanding skill-based systems in gaming history, with some truly ridiculously skilled players demonstrating absolute Olympian mastery over this system. See if you can spot the difference between me and one of the best players in the world. A bottomless list of moves, tons of ways to link them together, and endless approaches to maximizing your combo score. You can cut your losses and end your combo at any time, but huge rewards await if you keep building up your combo multiplier. The deep end is optional, but ever-present. The level of challenge naturally scales with your ambition. And, stop me if this sounds familiar, every player ends up developing their own style with this risk-reward system, where you're constantly achieving a dual purpose of looking cool while increasing your score, and alternating between thinking several steps ahead and simply surrendering to instinctive improv. So, Tony Hawk as inspiration for Spider-Man. It's honestly a thought that had never occurred to me until Miles Morales, because this game moved from the core of the system being about building and maintaining momentum, like the series had up to that point, to encouraging you to take stylish risks so you're able to do even cooler moves. So let's up the stakes. Let's make it a lot easier to bail, if you will, when performing those optional moves. Why not make a wipeout possible even after shooting out a web? If you're going out of your way to be a crazy daredevil, that's the risk you take. We can also implement a penalty. Let's lose some of that venom we've been earning so that the risk of failure is even greater. And let's reward you even more for avoiding mistakes. We'll import the Tony Hawk combo system, where your score gets multiplied as you pull off more tricks. So the rate at which you build up and bank venom boosts will increase as long as you keep chaining moves together quickly enough. Ultimately, we have a lot to gain, as well as a lot more to lose. That's a pretty direct approach for making things engaging and thrilling. And since we'll no doubt be playing as Peter again in the next game, we'll have to maintain this added depth by giving Pete his own set of revamped air tricks and a new boost mechanic as well. We could use a timed speed boost, like some of the classic games, or maybe a temporary boost to all movement speed for 10 seconds or so, like the suit power buffs from the first game. We could even go with something out of the box and never before seen, like introducing the web wings, and letting us maintain our built-up momentum and steer in any direction for a while. Take a page from Batman's book. It would certainly keep each protagonist feeling distinct from the other. And why don't we make use of a maxed out boost meter for a super boost, the equivalent of this for traversal. So do you want to spend a boost immediately, or build up to a really powerful one? More trade-offs, more choices. And then let's blow out the scale of the air trick system even further. Even more analog combinations, even more moves, and unique animations for both Peter and Miles with their signature styles all the way through. And why don't we add mid-swing tricks as well? Having control over exactly what your character's doing is key to expressiveness, so let's avoid making those swing animations random. We can still transition in smoothly from air tricks, but being able to voluntarily trigger your favorite signature Spidey poses, like this one, or this one, would be a nice touch. Tricking on and off your webs. And then we can avoid repetitive animations for dismounting your swings too. That way, a player can always end up in a regular or backward dive when they want to, rather than having access to these moves and their associated trick sets be a matter of chance. After all, Tony Hawk never gives you random animations. You know exactly what you're gonna get with every input. And lastly, there's still some room to make things more fluid. Although the air tricks are a lot more responsive now than they were in 2018, there's still some clunk, as it's often impossible to perform the air trick of your desire without first seeing a snippet of an unrelated animation. Having your charge jump disabled because you accidentally triggered a parkour flip is also no fun. Auto parkour if you must, but don't hold us back when we're trying to launch off a building at max velocity. The speed limit in Insomniac's first game is confirmed to be the result of hardware streaming limitations, so with the PS5 solid-state drive, there's no reason not to let us go at some really reckless breakneck speeds, especially when swinging out of a boost or a dive. And for some reason, wall crawling has been weirdly awkward and borderline broken from the start, with strange barriers to movement, uninterruptible animations, and a confusing camera. And since it's one of the webhead's signature abilities, it would be great to have the crawling gameplay exhibiting the same polish as the rest. And seriously, uninterruptible animations have no place in a Spider-Man game's traversal system. Clambering onto a rooftop, that little pause after a dodge. I mean, if Nathan Drake's animations can play out without interruptions, then certainly Spider-Man's ought to as well. And if Nate can shoot while running, why can't Spidey fire off webs in mid-swing? Then there's the weird floatiness that ensues when you try to swing at street level, like there's a magnetic force repelling you and stunting your swings. Sure, it's great that you don't find yourself having your swings interrupted all the time, but the artificial imposition is a little too noticeable here, and I'd love to see a more nuanced solution. Maybe we don't want to have our swings cut short, but it would be cool to see an in-game animation like this for skimming along the ground between cars, or to have Spidey automatically pull himself up his web to avoid a collision. We've got plenty of contextual animations to keep things moving elsewhere. Let's see some creative solutions to low-altitude swinging. And curbing some of these weird physics behaviors could be nice too. Let us do weird creative stuff while still clinging to our web, and don't automatically eject us after traveling 180 degrees. Hardly essential, but I know from experience there's a lot of fun to be had messing with web lines and pendulum physics. It's a little disappointing now to go back to the original game. The fastest moves you can perform are just those vanilla ones available to you at any time. There's no traversal benefit to performing air tricks. There's a lot more moments where there's little to do but wait, and your hands have nothing useful to do with the controller in the meantime. Playing Spider-Man 2018 now is an experience almost like stripping takedowns out of the combat system. Takedowns, after all, exhibit that same combination of strategic significance and extra style. If Insomniac managed to take such a big leap forward in just 2 years, while getting acquainted with PS5 architecture, remastering the previous game, and developing a new Ratchet & Clank, there's no telling how much further the team can take their system when building from the ground up for PS5 and putting together everything they've learned up to this point for a fully fledged sequel. And that's why Miles Morales has me so excited for the future of web swinging.